Good morning, Stanley.
Good morning, Eileen.
恭喜发财！
万事如意。
嗨嗨嗨，Good morning, everyone.
大家早上好。
早上好，今天是年初四，对吗？
是的，大年初四，大家捞了鱼生了吗？
捞 了，你呢？你捞几次了？
三次了，
Wow, this is good. And the beautiful part about lao yi sheng is the raw fish salad. And you can substitute the fish with so many different kind of meats, you know, and it's salad, right? So healthy.
还有一个哦，我的孩子哦，捞鱼生哦，他的华文进步了，
哦 对对对。
因为要读什么步步高升啊，黄金满地啊，哇，他的成语就很多了。
Yes, for sure. Wow. So welcome listeners to another episode of Motivation Monday. Yay. So this is episode 16. It is the concluding episode for the seventh stage. Yeah. It's an exciting stage for sure. Yay. So you can see. Junti, why do you think we have a different icon in the middle?
哇哦，这个好像是有两条路可以走啊，为什么有两条路呢？
This is the interesting part. So I think during interview, most of us would like to not feel nervous, right? So we already said in the last episode, and if you haven't watched, please go back and watch the last episode. Basically, we are saying that interview is a time for you to shine like the star. So why should we be panicking, right? Why should you have a star that is panicking? You should be shining. And so you have to find another route. You have to change. You have to change the way you perform during the interview. But of course, the common question is, how can I overcome the fear when I get into the interview? How can I do that and yet go in with a growth mindset? So, you know, what can we do? And therefore, I think what we can do here, one of the suggestions is to do this. Now, in one of the episodes, we also mentioned how you can go into an interview or have a career conversation to uncover jobs in such a way when anybody who interact with you sees that you are such a pleasure to interact with. People find it so interesting to interact with you, and therefore you must think of how you can be a pleasure. So one of the way is to go in there and not say, you know, pick me, hire me. And I remember it's still happening right now, you know. So we have a lot of job seekers who meet someone, and again, the first thing they will probably come back after I've introduced them with comments like, you know, Eileen, they don't have jobs. They don't have jobs for me. They have jobs, but not for me. And some of them look at the job market and then they say it's bad. Well, we know right now it's a lot of it is employers market. And we know it's brought about by the pandemic. And so we should change our mindset and not have this pick me and pick me and pick me, because that is more self-serving. Instead, we should have the mindset of glad we met, which means we want the interviewer, after meeting you, to leave with this mindset and these thoughts. I'm so glad we met. It's great talking to you. You know, it's so nice that our path crossed. And so in order to do that, what we can do is, how can I be like a musical greeting card? How can I be such a pleasure to interact with? Well, I've thought of three ways. Of course, I think there are definitely more than three ways, but let's look at the three ways to make it simple. The first way is, how can we get into this interview session and make them want to listen to you? Let's try and understand a little bit of that. Method number two is this. How can we perform during the interview and subtly make the interviewer learn a new fact? Come on, you and I, all of us would like to learn new things. If you look at the YouTube in videos, the videos that get a lot of viewings are videos on hacks. You know, hacks. What are some of the things we can do to reuse the everyday stuff to help us improve and be a lot more productive? So productivity hacks seems to be very popular. Well, same thing during interview. Perhaps what we can do is to help the interviewer learn something, but in a nice, subtle, and professional way. And the third one actually is to make them look forward. So, you know, every time job seekers will be asking after the interview, how long after the interview should I email or should I text or should I even ask the question like, have you guys made up your mind? Was I shortlisted? Am I shortlisted? What's next for me? Am I still in the game? There's so many questions. I don't think the interviewer will be looking forward to your email if that is the way. So is there another way? Yes, there is another way. We're going to explore that. All right. So you notice all these three methods start with alphabet.
L.
Yes. Alphabet. L, definitely. So go in there, go to the interview, think of these three words that start with alphabet L, right? Go into the interview, helping the interviewer to listen. Yes, I did say helping the interviewer to listen, all right? So we're going to learn a technique. We're going to learn a bit of the signs and then, of course, the art. And the second one is going to an interview, helping the interviewer to learn something. Of course, you're not going to say, and you know, be on your high horse and say, well, don't you know about this, you know, or maybe I shouldn't explain to you because it's beyond you. And the third one is, of course, help them to look forward. So let's look at method number one, how to make them listen.
Hey, Yulin, 等一下，这一个哦，刚好我有一个成语，让我分享一下这个听啊。 让吸引人家去听啊，让我分享。好吧。<笑>看到吗？这一句成语叫做"引人入胜"。那这是一个在宋朝哦，南宋一位刘义庆文学家他写的一本《世说新语》。 里面有讲这句话，引人入胜，就是说吸引别人哦，去到他的故事里面。哦，那我就讲一个故事吧，这个故事是很精彩的。相信有些人已经懂得这个故事，叫做《桃花源记》。
Oh, I don't know.
That would be very nice. That's why I look forward to桃花。对对对，新年桃花，我刚好讲这个故事，很贺新年的气氛，对不对？Yes, please. <笑>好，桃花，桃花源记啊，他写了一本小说了。那其实这位文学家是陶渊明，那他生长的时代哦，是在春秋战国时代，那个时候都是一直在打仗的，一直在打仗。 所以他希望是说有一个世外桃源哦，就是一个很安静、很宁静的一个社会，希望他，所以他才写出这样的一个故事。好，他是说从前有一个渔夫，他每次都去打鱼哦，那他打鱼就是在那个河流那边打鱼啦。那有一天呢，他打鱼，哎。 看到，哎，忽然间看到一片桃花源哦，哎，怎么这样多桃花？然后呢，他走到那个河流的尽头哦，哎，看到有一个小洞，一个小小的洞，一座山，那么看到一个小洞，他讲，而且小洞那边有光出来，他讲，哎，他要进去看看，他走进去看看，他开始走进去的时候，那个洞很小。 很窄，然后越走越走，它洞就越来越宽，越来越大。然后呢，他就看到一个景象，他吓了一跳，哇，这个是什么地方啊？你 他的物质非常的整齐又很漂亮，那么呢，还有啊，那边的人啊都很友善，那些那个地方啊，那个你看啊，在我们的左手边很多的梯田啊，梯田就是那些种米的，哇，好漂亮哦，那么人们呢丰衣足食哦，哎，是一个很漂亮的一个景象，哇，那他从来没有见过的，因为 他处在的时代是打战的时代，每个人都在跑，在逃嘛，哦，他看到这样的一个，他就很像，他就走进去，刚好那边村里的人看到他，就说，诶，你从哪里来的？啊，他说那个渔夫说我是从外面进来的，哦，那里面的人就说我在，我是因为逃难了，因为有战争我才逃来这里的。 那我逃来进来这里之后，我就不再出去了。哇，那么那个渔夫哦，就哇，在这边受到那些村人的招待，在那边住啊、吃啊，3天之后，他说我要走了，我要走了，我还是要回去看看我家人哦。然后他走出去的时候，他很聪明，他就放记号哦，所以呢，他等以后他可以回来嘛。那么他就回到他的村，回到他的家乡之后呢？ 他就告诉那边的村长说，有这样的一个地方，叫他们根据这个记号来到这个地方。所以那些村人就赶快啊，哇，划船啊，跑来，但是找来找去找不到了，找不到这个地方了，永远找不到了。所以呢，陶渊明讲的这个故事哦，这是很引人入胜啊，让人很想去哦。到今天为止，还是很多人在找这个地方。 有些人说我找到了，我找到了，我找到这个地方了，就是在某某地方哦，就是因为他的故事太过精彩了，让人家呢就一直在想要追他的故事，一直要想要怎么样的走入他的故事中哦，这就是我要分享的引人入胜。
Wow, this is good. I like that. And even you telling the story itself, it caused me to 引我入胜. No, it's so good. I think you have to tell the story in a way that makes people want to listen even more. And that's exactly what we need to do. Okay, so I've got something to share as well. I think what you have shared here is, very, very relevant. And I think prior to that, we said that how can we make them want to listen? So you have already shared, in the ancient times, there are already, stories that make people want to listen. And the more they listen, the more they uncover. Well, let me tell you, there is a theory behind this. Number one is, have you heard of metronome? The equipment that helps the musical player, whether you're playing the guitar or the piano, it keeps you in rhythm. Okay, now there is actually some kind of physics behind it. So, the science behind that, I'm gonna let you see this short video. It's on a few metronomes having different start times, but yet they synchronize. Ah, let's take a look at this, okay?
神奇呀、啊，好神奇！
And now you're thinking the last one, right?
对，
Ah,
哇，全部都排在一起了，哇，好神奇，好神奇，哇！
fantastic, right? So you might be thinking, what make the metronomes all move in the same direction? Is this? There is this moving board below all the metronomes, and this board is made movable by the cans. Well, you can use a lot of things, but you actually use your story to move everyone in the same direction. Now, is this something that is taught by us? No, of course not. So the science behind that is actually discovered by Dr. Yuri. So Dr. Yuri is, he basically examines and studies how the brain works. And and based on this, he calls this a neural entrainment. What you have seen just now is physical entrainment. So when you talk about neural entrainment, all of us think in our own what we call brainwave, okay? And that's why this phrase that comes out, we're on the same wavelength. This is how it comes about, all right? So all of us think in a certain wavelength, and this is, you know, well, we are not interrupted at all. So naturally, we all think in our own wavelength. But the moment two people come together, one is speaking and one is listening, and if you manage to tell your story, and your story becomes the movable board. If your story is interesting and use the approach, which is what Stanley has shared with us, right? Stanley talked about 引人入胜. So you have to tell your story such that people kind of pace along with you. And when you pace along with you, the frequencies actually go in the same tandem. So that's why you are able to get people, right, your audience, to listen with you, pace with you. But you need to know how to pace with them, help them to pace as well, all right? So as long as, just trust us, when you get into an interview, help to give a story, tell about your background in the form of a story, such that you allow the interviewer, who's the listener in this case, to follow your frequency. What does this mean? It only means that during interview, do not give too short an answer. Well, you should be answering to the point, but you shouldn't stop there. You should maybe give the answer in the first sentence, but prepare about 3 to 4 sentences more to substantiate. But substantiate in a sense of telling the story itself, unfolding the story, but not in the sense of let me justify, right? Justify, let me qualify, let me, you know, just to unveil the truth because I'm not lying here. It's not so much that. So don't take a defensive approach, but take a more conversational approach, okay? So that's method number one. And if you look at the method number two, next, we're going to learn how to help them to learn.
学习要教怎么帮他们学习，对，让我来说说一个故事吧。好吧
，Second story, let's listen.
是的，第二个故事是孔子的一个经典的名言哦，他说：“视其所以，观其所由，察其所安。”就是说他的意思、啊、就是说你做任何事情，你第一你要先去看看这一个人，然后呢再 观察、哦、他的身体语言，他的讲的话，然后最后呢再想想看他到底是要说什么。那 我现在来分享、啊、分享这一个一个经典的故事、就是由这三个看观跟观跟察、我们来看看。
Cool.
在春秋战国时期、哦、你看你们在你们的右手边有三个国家，一个是宋国、哦、一个是齐国，宋国是蓝色的那个，那齐国是在上面，楚国是在下面、哦，那齐国呢要攻打宋国，宋国不是很紧张吗？因为他 很害怕吗？他就宋王、啊、就叫一个叫做张孙子 的人跑去跟楚王叫他求救， 叫楚王求助，哎，楚王你可以帮我吗？他就说，哎，齐国要攻打宋国，楚国可以派兵相助吗？楚王说，好，很好，我可以派兵相助。然后呢，他就过后呢，他就回去了。那么在回去的路程中呢，车夫他有一个车夫哦，车夫载他回去的，那个时候是马车啦。然后车夫就看到为什么张孙子哦，他很愁，很不快乐。他说：“你已经求到救兵了，楚王说要愿意来帮你啊，为什么你还是这样的担心呢？”然后张孙子他说了三样东西，他说：“第一，我听到楚王说答应的太快了，我一跟他讲就马上答应，也就是说他没有想。”他没有跟我坐下来一起讨论啊，我们要怎么样做怎么样做，他就直接说好，我答应帮助你，所以他不是诚心的。第一，他看了。第二呢，宋国我们是一个小国，齐国强大，楚王一定不会得罪齐国的，因为他大吗？为什么为了我这个小国而跟他打？所以他看到楚王的身体语言 body language 就知道了他是不会帮我们的，再加上他的 tone， 他的语气说好，我一定会帮你啊，这个就是不是很真诚的。最后呢，楚王为什么呢？他自己有一个后面的想法，为什么呢？他希望呢，齐国攻打楚国，那么齐国呢，就他的兵越来越少吗？对不对？他你打，让楚国就会可以去打回齐国。所以他的想法是最好你们两个打仗，最后我来收拾你们。所以呢，是不是张孙子他用了看还有观察他的身体语言，然后呢再想想这个人他背后在想什么，对不对啊？所以呢，这个就是我讲的视其所以，观其所由，察其所安，这就是我要讲的。
Wow, this is cool. This is a subtle way of helping the other party to learn, right? Yes, very, very nice. Yeah, I think what we can do during interview, just a quick one, is to help the interviewer to learn by using this simple framework. And this simple framework is called the STAR framework. The STAR framework simply means, and still keeping in line with the first technique of helping them to listen, because you don't want to share a certain fact, you know, like remember I mentioned the hack, the productivity hack, you don't want to share in a way that helps them to go to sleep. you want to make it interesting. So how can you help them to follow your logic? Number one, talk about the situation, describe the situation. And that leads to either the problem, all right? The problem or the opportunities. So if it is the problem or an opportunity, you might want to talk about what are some of the essential tasks that needs to be carried out in order to take advantage of it or to resolve the problem. And the third one would be A. A stands for the final actions that were taken. So essentially what it means is what was taken in the end, right? So under the same circumstances, your situation, the situation that happened, what actually happened in the end? So the actions that were taken. So every time there's a slight confusion between the T and the A, T are the essential tasks that needs to happen, but finally, what were the actions that were taken? And then of course, what was the result or the outcome? I think if you keep this logic in mind, it helps the listener to follow your logic. And as they follow your logic, they'll be following your frequency as well. So this should be a useful thing to keep in mind as you help the other party, which is the interviewing panel, to learn something about your area of work. Because another common mistake that I've seen, job seekers going in thinking that the interviewer doesn't understand the situation at all. I always say this, if you're able to explain a somewhat complex issue in a way that it sounds like a story. Number two, there is some nuggets of information to take away. It helps the other party to want to listen more and also leave with something. So I think the second part, learn, will be a good one because people will like, everybody loves to learn anyway. It's one of our 24 happy genes. Okay. So now that we've heard two techniques, we're going to be hearing the last one, which is a common question. What happens after the entire interview ends, right? How to make them look forward to you? So on this point, we will be teaching you the third method.
哎，等一下，等一下，你还没有讲第三个的时候，古代的人早就知道怎么用了。
啊 ，OK， 来你来讲吧。
好吧，我就讲古代人是怎么用他们的方法。哦，
他们也有一个方法来。
好，你等一下啊，让我来share那个 screen 吧。
好的 ，I like the drawing so far。Especially the first one. Whoa, all the flowers.
好，好，这一句是谚语，放长线钓大鱼。
Wow.
这个是一个民间的一个谚语，那么是由清朝的石金城作家，在他的一本《传家宝三集》的俗谚里面写的一句话。那他的意思，如果你要钓到大鱼，你就要很长的线哦，只要短线就不能够钓大鱼啊。来，我讲一个故事吧，啊，让你们印象会比较深刻。
好吧。
好，那在东汉啊，东汉时期有一个汉官叫做张让，张让是一个很有势力的人，非常有势力。那么每次啊，他下面呢，啊，就有很多人呢，啊，去接见他。这些人呢，啊，都是官来的，都来接见他，来请教他等等。啊，那这个刚好有一个商人叫做孟陀，孟陀就看到，哇，如果这些人我能够认识这些人，不是很好吗？是不是？因为他做生意嘛，如果他可以跟这些人、这些官人，交朋友，那以后他就有更多生意，对不对？他就在想，我要怎么样做呢？然后他想到一个好办法。他呢，因为这个当然，哦，他有很多仆人、佣人，他有很多仆人，哦，所以呢，他就去帮助他下面的仆人。他就呢，就是他张让的家奴，他家里的那些帮他做的工作的人，他就帮助他。如果这个人他需要，他没有钱买米，他就给他钱买米。他就如果这个人需要衣服没有钱，他也给他钱。他就帮助他们，帮助这一些人。那这些人呢，他就不是帮助一次哦，他帮助了一段时间，一直帮助他，一直帮助他，一直帮助他。那有一天呢，这些人也不好意思啦，我受到你帮助这样久，他就问这个商人孟陀，哎，请问你需要我们帮什么的吗？他就说，哦，其实哦，我只要你们帮我一件事而已，也就是说，当你们的张让大人他接见这些官人的时候，我也会到在场，当到时你们全部来围着我就可以了，跟我叩头就可以了。啊，所以呢，那天呢，刚好呢，很多人去找那个张让，哦，你看很多官员书生都去跟张让讲话。这时呢，商人孟陀呢，又看到张让的仆人呢，去找孟陀跟他鞠躬行礼。那这些官人就说，哇，这个孟陀是怎么样的人啊，为什么他当然家里的人全部对他这样尊敬啊，我要去认识他一下，他要去认识他一下。所以呢，孟陀呢这一招呢，哇，最后呢他认识很多很多的官人，他认识很多官人，因为呢他开始就是去帮助别人，让别人 觉得说哎呀他的人太好我可以帮他什么结果他就认识更多的人啊这就是我要说的
So nice, yes. And I think it's all about seeing the bigger picture as well and helping others first before, you know, having the benefit of being hired, which means it is a benefit to yourself. So really put others first before getting what you want. So on this last part, in line with what you have mentioned, how can we make them look forward? And I think if you recall last episode, we spoke about classical conditioning. We talk about Pavlov dogs, right? We talk about how Pavlov dogs, when they hear the bell ring, the immediate action was the dog started to salivate, right? In anticipation that they're gonna get food. But they did not salivate looking at the food itself. It's just by hearing the sound of the bell. And so in the end, the reward did come. So, you know, when we talk about the power of habit, what you want to do going into the interview is to allow and make it such that you keep sharing nuggets of gold, nuggets of information, find a way to discover, you know, what interests the interviewer themselves. So, in this case, the cue that we are talking about is to pair your email, your instant messages, or even your phone call. Of course, we don't recommend doing that as your first attempt. Always just send something which is more distant first because you are respectful of their time. So something like an email. What's in your email? Imagine if every time I get your email, I open your email, the first thing I read is, can you tell me the status of the interview? It's self-serving. It doesn't serve me, it serves you. So it doesn't help me, you know, opening your email or receiving your text if you are so fortunate to have the phone number of the interviewer. Be respectful as well. Do not use that to abuse your relationship such that every email that comes through, every text that comes through is self-serving. And so what you want to do is condition them, right? Classical condition. Every time your email comes in, your instant message comes on the, let's say, WhatsApp, WeChat, text, or your phone call, it's all about making sure that they get some benefit. And then, only then, you will find that they will always reply, because that's the action you want from them. You want them to reply you, right? You always want them to reply you. So your first email going back is to thank them, but and find something else to pair with that thank you email. All right, don't stop there and say thank you for the interview and then that's it. Find another information that will go with it. And therefore, every email that comes in, there's always some, let's say, productivity hack, right, to include in your message. Now, for sure, they will reply you. So first, you condition them. But what is the reward? The reward that you have to give yourself. Remember, we talk about classical conditioning. We talk about the power of habit. The last part is always forgotten because you are waiting for their reply. If they do not give you a reply, you don't reward yourself. In fact, you feel very disappointed. No. We already spoke about it in the last episode. We said that give yourself a reward, regardless of what the reply, what the action is, the outcome is. So the reward is, well, to yourself, you could say, well, I learned something about this particular interviewer. Maybe that email did not sound exciting enough. Maybe I should share something else. You know, look beyond. Look back at what Stanley have mentioned as well. See the bigger picture, help others first. You never know, the opportunity could come later. You might say, but Eileen, you know, there's no opening in that company. Why should I bother getting to know the HR? Why should I bother getting to know even the GM CEO, you know, or managing director of that company, of that Singapore, you know, representative office? Because it's part of a global office, but the regional HQ is not in Singapore, it's in China or anywhere else, right? Why should I get to know them? Hey, you never know. You never know when you need them. So look at the bigger picture. That's what I think you know, we can actually live and teach ourselves. So on that note, we actually cover the tips that you can take away for stage seven. And the next two episodes, we will be covering stage eight, which we have never covered before, which is how can you go into the negotiation phase, all right? So really, really exciting. And we hope that you tune in again. So that's episode 17 and 18, all about money, money, money. So, so I hope you have been, you know, listening to all the episodes and find today's episode exceptionally interesting. So I wish you all the best. I'm Eileen.
I'm Stanley.
And you have been listening to 东谈西说
Motivation Monday.
Yay!
Yeah, 大家心想事成，事事如意。
Yes, and I will also wish you all the best. Please collect as many ang paos as possible. And maybe even give out, right? Give out as many ang paos as possible as well. So until next episode, keep the treasures close to you. Yeah, so all the best and be happy. Yay!